Welcome to Screen Crush. I'm Ryan Airy. The trailer for The Batman just dropped at DC Fandome after writer-director Matt Reeves gave a lengthy discussion about why he loves Batman.
As I said, Batman doesn't have the sort of the ability to have sort of superheroic powers. He just has superheroic focus and superheroic drive.
And if you have time, you should really watch the whole panel. It's great. So let's break down this trailer and all of the Easter eggs and little references that you might have missed. Now, even before we see any footage, we know this is going to be a different kind of Batman movie. That's the sound of duct tape. Not some kind of super criminal sci-fi adhesive, duct tape. Because this movie takes place in a grounded, real world. So this is presumably Paul Dano's Riddler murdering a rich guy. Later, we see newspaper clippings of Don Mitchell Jr. winning re-election. So let's assume that this is the Riddler's victim. Now notice in these clippings, there's also this tiny headline that says seawall construction stalled. That could be important. Matt Reeves cited Chinatown as one of the major influences for this movie.
Like Chinatown was a key one because Chinatown, Jake Gitte's, in investigating that sort of the series of crimes that were part of that story, he discovers the depth of corruption in Los Angeles.
Now, an important subplot in that film was about water rights and irrigation. So I'm wondering if this construction project ties into the greater mystery, and this is just a tiny breadcrumb clue. Matt Reeves said this is year two for this Batman. So he's evolving as a character, and so is Gotham City. This is still an incredibly corrupt town, similar to what we saw in the comic book Batman Year One. We've seen hints of Gotham's corruption in other movies, usually a crooked cop or two. But in this movie, the corruption goes all the way to the top.
Then the murders begin to describe sort of the history of Gotham in a way that only reinforces what he knows about Gotham, but it opens up a whole new world of corruption that went much farther.
Later on, Riddler tells Batman to open his eyes, meaning to see the corruption that's choking the city.
What is the price for your blind eye?
So, a young Jim Gordon arrives at the crime scene. He's not the commissioner, but you can tell he's respected and has a higher position in the department. This newspaper reads Maroney Drug Bust. In the comics, this is the mobster that Harvey Dent put on trial who splashed acid on his face and turned him into Two-Face. So this could be a subtle hint that Harvey Dent is somewhere in this universe. Gordon and the cops are clearly working with the Batman, which is interesting because later on in the trailer, we see the Batman facing off against the police. I'm guessing that Batman gets too close to uncovering the corrupt police commissioner, so then he declares open season on the Bat. Like here, we see Batman losing temper at some police, maybe like he's finally fed up with this dirty cop. And later, he uses a grappling hook to travel through a staircase, and you can see police shooting at it. Matt Reeves also said that this is first and foremost a detective story. Batman is the world's greatest detective, but we haven't seen that side of him too often in the movies.
The poison only works when the components are mixed. Hairspray won't do it alone, but hairspray mixed with lipstick and perfume will be toxic.
The Riddler leaves him a green envelope that's a nice Easter egg to his uniform from the comics. The envelope contains a greeting card with an owl, which could be a reference to the Court of Owls from Batman The Long Halloween. That's a mystery story from the comics that involves Batman's entire rogues gallery, very similar to this movie. But notice there's also a skeleton on the card, maybe pointing Batman to the gang of kids with skull makeup that he beats up later on in the trailer. Now notice that he's left a clue for Batman, several scrawl marks for him to decipher. I have actually already decoded these. You know what they say? This is your mom. The Batman suit looks awesome. Now the bat symbol on the front is actually made up of two halves of a gun, maybe the gun that killed Thomas and Martha Wayne. This suit is basically riot gear that he's adapted, and you can see all the little dings and bullet scars carved into it. And this, of course, is former White House advisor Steve Bannon playing corrupt police commissioner Loeb. Bruce Wayne is watching this press conference, which was actually shot in downtown Liverpool. Reeves said they shot in Liverpool to get a base of Gothic architecture, then they're adding more modern elements with CG. So hopefully Gotham won't look like any city that we recognize. Andy Serkis's Alfred gets a small voiceover as Bruce rolls into the new Batcave.
You're becoming quite a celebrity.
So, let's talk about this new HQ. It's clearly made from a pre-existing structure, note these two long staircases, and it's probably underground as indicated by these struts and the ceiling supports here. Now since we've seen him drive through a graveyard, I'm guessing this is an underground mausoleum on the Wayne property. It's appropriate since Batman has never been able to let go of his parents' murder. So emotionally, they're always with him, and he's operating underground where they're buried, so they're physically with him as well. Or it could be an abandoned train depot that Bruce Wayne or his family bought years ago. This would allow him access to the entire city by using subway tunnels. You can see that it's also kind of sparse. There's no trophies, no gadgets, or planes. This is because he's new at this, but also to emphasize that this is just a guy. putting on a suit and beating criminals' asses. You can also see his bat cycle here. It's not like he's going to be riding that thing around in the daytime. Then there's a few shots from this funeral, probably the mayor's, where a car crashes into a church with DOA, dead on arrival, written on the side and top. There's a hostage with a smartphone and a note for the Batman. Now, I'm wondering if the mystery in this movie can be solved by the audience. Like, will a clever Encyclopedia Brown fan be able to decipher these clues along with the bat? Later in the trailer, the Batman is nearby when this guy's bomb explodes. So it's likely that everyone, including Bruce Wayne, evacuated and then he returned a bit later as Batman. You can even see the bomb defusing robot here. Then Zoe Kravitz's Selina Kyle is breaking into a crime scene, probably the mayor's house. They shot 25% of this movie before the world ended, so it would make sense if they shot all of the footage on this same set. And the Batman fights her here later on. She's most likely breaking in here because the place is abandoned and it's easy pickings for a cat burglar. Next, there's a transformed Colin Farrell as Oswald Cobblepot, the Penguin. Matt Reeves said he's still rising up the criminal ladder, and at this point, he doesn't even like being called the Penguin. He's supervising or involved in some sort of deal here involving a crooked recycling center, while the Batman watches from high above. Now later you can see Cobblepot firing at someone, probably the Batman, and then later after that he's in a car chase to get away from him.
This guy's crazy!
So Batman interrupts this deal and kicks off a high-speed chase. Then we see a few flashes of this gang of kids wearing white face makeup. Now they could be a Skull Gang, or they could be the Jokers. This was a street gang from Batman Beyond that were inspired by the exploits of the Joker in the distant past.
I told you not to speak!
So does this mean that some form of the Joker, maybe Arthur Fleck, has already existed in this universe? Well, maybe. At the end of the Joker, he's inspired people to wear his face and he's become a cult figure. Or, more likely, this universe's Joker could come out of this street gang and take control of them. After all, the Joker movie took place in 1982 when Bruce was about 9, 10, and iPhones exist in this universe, so the timing doesn't add up. But this lead guy does have stitching makeup at the corners of his mouth, implying that he's emulating a version of the Joker like Heath Ledger's with a Glaswegian smile. You can even see this kid filming with an iPhone when we get this line.
The hell are you supposed to be?
And I love that we're expecting him to say this classic line.
What are you?
I'm Batman.
I am
Batman.
I'm Batman.
I'm Batman.
I'm Batman.
No, you're not. I'm Batman.
I'm Batman.
You sound like Cookie Monster.
But instead...
I'm Vengeance.
That's freaking brutal. Let's watch it again.
I'm Vengeance.
Now, if a guy in a Joker mask did kill Batman's parents, that would explain this brutality. One of them gets off a shot against Batman, and he just takes it. Again, rookie Batman. In later years, he would never risk taking a shot point blank. Then we get a good look at the new Batmobile. Notice it has the booster engine on the back, but also these panels that have been riveted and welded into place, showing us that this is not slick, it's a homemade job. All of this gear is stuff that he was able to make on his own. I love the new logo and title. Notice the bat ears on the A as it forms. And the final lines.
You're part of this too.
How am I part of it?
You'll see.
Imply there's a shared connection here between Batman, the Riddler, and all of this corruption.
Without being an origin tale for him, it ends up being something that touches on his origins. That is, it starts to describe this epic history of corruption in Gotham that you start to understand, well, where did my family sit in that?
Maybe the Riddler has even worked out the greatest mystery, Batman's secret identity, and he's about to unveil that the Wayne's murder was part of some greater city corruption. But what did you guys think of this trailer? Who do you think should play Joker in this universe? Let me know in the comments below. And if it's your first time here, please subscribe. For ScreenCrush, I'm Ryan Airy.